You ever heard of a bizarre series filled with wild adventures? No? Well, I'd advise you check out JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. This is weird for me to say, but yes, I am a JoBro. I enjoy watching buff men beat the absolute shit out of each other while wearing designer clothing. Besides all the jokes, I do enjoy JoJo's. And this may be a hot take, but part 2 is my favorite. Back when it was simpler times, back when Hamon was the main power system and Joseph had to use his wits to get the upper hand on his enemies. I could talk about how much I love Battle Tendency all day, but that's not why I made this video. JoJo's is known for a lot of things: their memes, inside jokes, their poses, their loud sound effects, their pop art like edits, their sound scores, their character designs. JoJo's has a lot of selling factors, but above all that, JoJo's is known for their villains. And today I wanted to talk about a specific villain, Sea Dog v. Yoshikage Kira. After finishing part 3, I felt as if I was leaving a roller coaster of emotions, so many ups in suspense and so many downs of pure intensity. As much as I enjoyed part 3, I needed a break. I needed something that was more of a slice of life, but I didn't want to watch Orange or something. I wanted JoJo's. No, I needed JoJo's. And that's when I decided, fuck it. I trust Araki Sensei.
Good morning!
Part 4 was perfect. The art style, the characters, the episodic-like pacing, the jingle. It was a breath of fresh air. While the other parts felt more like a huge giant adventure, part 4 felt like a bundle of adventures. The main cast was fun and dynamic. The strong protagonist, the delinquent friend who wasn't too bright in the head, the short friend. It kinda sounds like I'm talking about Yu Yu Hakusho. But all jokes aside, I really did enjoy part 4. But out of all the things I enjoyed most, nothing sold me more than part 4's antagonist. A man fixated with hands and being organized. He lives a normal life, or at least he wants to.
My name is Kira Yoshikage, age 33.
Kira's introduction alone sells the character. Compared to all of the other JoJo villains, Kira stands on top. Sorry, DL fanboys. Kira's presence felt the most intimidating. He was unpredictable. There were times where I didn't know what he would do because of his previous actions. The man was a ticking time bomb, no pun intended. I could easily talk about his stand ability or how much of a menace he was, because he was a menace, but that isn't what made me like him. I enjoyed him because he wanted to be normal and simplistic, but instead was the most complex and irregular character out of the whole story. Quite ironic. I didn't think of this until I started making this video, but he reminds me a lot of Walter White from Breaking Bad. These two features on both characters could possibly be correlated with their popularity. You see, Kira could have easily been another run-of-the-mill, I'm a bad guy because I like to be evil situation, but it takes a truly twisted mind to believe their horrid actions are justified. That's a true villain. Kira is one of the best villains because he's the most normal. He desires a normal life. No, he believes he deserves a normal life. He doesn't have any outrageous goals, it's just about how he carries out his goals. The lengths he reaches to achieve his goals is the most inhumane and villainous thing about him. Same with Walter White, a man who wants to provide for his family becomes the most notorious meth cook, killing anybody who possesses a threat to him. You see the parallel? Kira is one of the best villains because he's the most normal, or should I say, realistic. I don't want to make this video into a diving into the mind of Kira sort of thing because it defeats the purpose of his character. He doesn't know why he does these things. He wants to be normal, so he tells himself he's normal. But I believe he's mistaken himself because, let's be honest, if he really wanted to be normal, he would separate himself from these urges he gets. I believe he wants to be free. Before continuing, I want to talk about how this man is accidentally a better husband than most people. He stole a whole identity, fought the urge to kill his wife, and in the midst of this, his wife was head over heels for him. Maybe I need to take notes, man. Getting back to what I stated, Yoshikage Kira doesn't want to be normal or live a normal life. He wants to be free. If he wanted to live a normal life, he could have considered attending therapy, turning himself in, or going to some sort of psych ward, or even leaving the vicinity of any woman with hands. Him escaping his past or trying to create a new identity only made his life all the more irregular. But again, that's what makes his character so interesting. I know I said I wasn't going to talk about his ability, but I changed my mind. To summarize, Kira's ability makes things go boom. At this point, stands are known to evolve with different stages, amplifying their abilities. Towards the end of part 3, Kira went from make thing go boom to make time loop. Let me ask you something. Would a man who wants to live a normal life want to explore a supernatural ability that allows him to decimate anything in his path to an extent where he can loop time? I'm starting to go on a tangent. Araki Sensei did a phenomenal job with this character. He created a character that I felt belonged in something like American Psycho or something. And where's all this leading to? I don't know. But all I can say is Kira is peak villainy, and I needed to express that.